In this lecture, I would like to discuss about thermodynamic functions of mixing. We know there are various thermodynamic functions like free energy, enthalpy, entropy. So what is the thermodynamic functions of mixing? So it is the difference between property of the mixture and total property of the pure component. So thermodynamic functions of mixing is the difference between property of the mixture and the property of the mixture of the pure components. So let us see the first free energy of mixing. That is delta G. The first function, that is free energy. So let us see the free energy of mixing. So it is denoted by this delta G. So it is the difference between the free energy of the mixing and the free energy of the mixing of the pure component. Now let us consider a vessel or a box with the three compartments. See here, suppose that this is a vessel or a box which is having the three compartments here, 1, 2, and 3. Okay. And the partitions of the compartments can be, the partitions of the compartments can be, remember, whenever it is required. Suppose that this is the partition, this is 1, 2, 3. Okay. Each compartment contains known volume of a pure gas. Each compartment, it is having the known volume of a pure gas. Okay, it is having the pure gas. Okay, which are at the same temperature and pressure. Everywhere temperature and pressure is constant. Same temperature, at constant temperature, pressure, at constant temperature, pressure, at constant pressure, temperature. Okay, so once again, let us see a vessel or box with the three compartments, and the partitions of the compartments can be remembered whenever it is required. Now each compartment contain a known volume of the gas. Okay, every compartment, it is having the known volume of the gas, and the temperature and pressure becomes constant here. Okay, the free energy of gases before mixing is given by, the free energy of gases before mixing is given by, before the mixing. Okay, so that is initial stage. So we can write here free energy of that gases in the initial state, it is equal to, okay, so we consider the three compartments, then it is equal to N1 mu 1 star plus N2 mu 2 star plus N3 mu 3 star, where star indicates the pure component. This is before the mixing. Okay, before the mixing, there are three compartments. So each compartment is having the pure gas of that component. So mu 1 star, it is the chemical potential. Okay, see now, let us once again represent the three compartments here. Okay, so you can see here three compartments, 1, 2, 3. So this mu 1 star, it is the chemical potential of this compartment, of this gas. This is mu 2 star. So star indicates the pure component, mu 3 gas, before the mixing. And their free energy, it is given by this N1 mu 1 star plus N2 mu 2 star plus N3 mu 3 star. Now this is before mixing. This is before mixing. Now let us see the free energy of the mixing, free energy of the gases after mixing. Okay, free energy of the gases after mixing. So it is G final. So it is given by G final, it is equal to after the mixing. Okay, so the gases are allowed to mix up. So after the mixing, now there is a change in the chemical potential, N1 mu1 plus N2 mu2 plus N3 mu3. Three components are there, where mu1 and mu2, mu3 are the chemical potential after the mixing. Okay. Now, in short, we can write this equation. Summation of Ni mu I. Okay, in short. Similarly, G initial is equal to summation of Ni mu I star. Okay. So we know these two equations now. Suppose that this is equation one here, and this is equation two here. So this is the free energy before the mixing in the initial stage, and this is the free energy after the mixing. Okay. Now let us see the difference between these two. So the free energy change of mixing is given by, that is delta G. Free energy change of mixing or thermodynamic function of mixing. So it is delta G of mixing, difference between these two. So it is equal to G final minus G initial. So G final, it is a summation of Ni mu I, and it is a summation of Ni mu I star. So we are getting this equation. Suppose that this is the equation three here. The delta G of mixing, free energy of mixing, it is the difference between, it is a difference between these two terms. Now, let us assume that the gases under consideration will be ideal. So for an ideal gas, we know the chemical potential relation, mu I is equal to mu I star plus RT ln P upon P0. Okay, the chemical potential can be related to this equation. That is mu I star, it is a pure component, RT ln P upon P0. But according to the Raoult's law, we know that P upon P0, it is equal to, this ratio, it is equal to mole fraction XI, mole fraction of that component. So therefore, this equation can be written as, suppose that this is equation four here. Okay. So this equation can be written as mu y equal to mu y star plus RT ln XI. So in this equation now, you can see delta G of mixing, it is equal to, so Ni, now mu y, it is equal to this mu I star. Okay. So Ni mu I star, then it is RT ln XI plus RT summation of Ni ln XI. And this is remains as minus summation of Ni mu I star. So these two terms get cancelled here. So free energy of mixing, it is equal to RT Ni ln XI. This is equation five. Once again, you have to see here, mu I becomes equal to, this is according to the definition of the chemical potential. Mu I, it is equal to mu I star plus RT ln XI. Okay, mole fraction, it is related to the chemical potential by this equation. So therefore, in this equation, we can write mu I here. Okay, so mu I, it is equal to Ni mu I star. So you can see Ni mu I star plus Now ni it is multiplied here, so rt ln ni xi. So these two terms get cancelled here. So finally we are getting this. This is equation 5. Free energy of mixing, it is equal to rt summation of ni ln xi. You can see here. Free energy of mixing, it is equal to rt summation of ni ln xi. Okay. Now, in this case, the mixture of gases contain three components. Three gases are there. Suppose that hydrogen gas, oxygen gas, and argon gas. Therefore, the equation can be written as, that equation can be written as the above equation, the equation which has been derived by us, that equation can be written as, so see now here, free energy of mixing, delta G of mixing. For three components, we can write the equation now. So that is RT. So this is now N1 ln X1 plus N2 ln X2 and plus N3 ln X3. Okay, for three components. Now for this equation, dividing the LHS and RHS in this equation with total number of moles, as we consider three gases. So N1 is the number of moles of the first gas, N2 is the number of mole of the second gas, and N3 is the number of mole of the third gas. So let us divide this by. So when free energy of mixing, it is divided by total number of moles, then it is called as molar free energy of mixing. So we cannot write as like of this, we can write delta G molar free energy of mixing as like of this. So we have to divide this equation now by the total number of moles. So when we write delta G of mixing and it is divided by this N1 plus N2 plus N3, then it should be equal to delta G, that is free energy of mixing, molar free energy of mixing. Similarly, on to the right hand side, you can see here. So now here N1, so divide by total number of moles, N1 plus N2 plus N3, ln X1. Similarly here, now this term, it is nothing but number of moles divided by total number of moles. It is called as a mole fraction. So supposed to be this is X1 here. Similarly, in this case, it is X2 here. Similarly, in this case, it is X3 here. So therefore, this equation will be changes now. This equation will be changes. So we can write now this equation, delta G of mixing, molar free energy of mixing, it is equal to RT. Now this is X1, X1 ln X1, plus X2 ln X2, plus X3 ln X3. Now in short, we can write the equation in this way, molar free energy of mixing, it is equal to RT summation of XI ln XI in general, okay? Or you can see the same equation is written here, molar free energy of mixing, it is equal to RT summation of XI ln XI. So we are getting this equation here. Molar free energy of mixing, it is equal to R is the gas constant, T is the temperature, XI is the mole fraction of ith component. Okay, so we are getting this equation. So from this equation, we can see that the free energy of mixing is negative. Molar free energy of mixing, it is negative. Why it is negative? Because the mole fraction, that is X, is always less than one. Mole fraction, we know that mole fraction, it is less than one, this value. Okay. So ln XY is negative. As mole fraction, it is less than one. Suppose that it is 0.9. Then what is ln 0.9? It is negative value. So molar free energy of mixing is also negative. It means that the mixing is a spontaneous process. Okay, mixing is a spontaneous process, and spontaneous mixing is accompanied by decrease in the free energy, because this delta G is negative here. Why we get delta G is negative? Because this ln xi value, it is negative here. As mole fraction, it is less than 1. So this value is negative. So ultimately delta G is negative. So spontaneous mixing is accompanied by decrease in free energy. Free energy get decreases. So in this way, we derive here the equation for molar free energy of mixing. That is, delta G of mixing, it is equal to RT summation of xi ln xi. Now, let us solve this problem. Show that the molar free energy of mixing in a binary gas mixture, binary means two gases only, molar free energy of mixing in a binary gas mixture is minimum when the two gases are present in the equimolar ratio. Two gases is having the equimolar ratio. Let us show this. Suppose that in a box, we have taken two gases. This is 1, 2. So the molar free energy of mixing, molar free energy of mixing in a binary gas mixture is minimum when the two gases are present in equimolar ratio. Equimolar ratio. Okay. It means that suppose that x1 is the mole fraction of this x2, it is equal to x2. So it is equal to 1/2. Okay. Because we know that x1 plus x2, it is equal to 1. So 1/2 plus 1/2, it is equal to 1. So we have to prove here now. We have to show this. X1 equal to X2 equal to 1/2. Okay. Half mole of this we have taken here. And half mole of this we have taken here. Okay. So we know this equation very well. Delta G of mixing, it is equal to RT XI ln XI. Now for two components, so we can write the equation here. Molar free energy of mixing, it is equal to RT X1 ln X1 plus X2 ln X2. Because two components are there. Now we know that X1 plus X2, it is equal to 1. Mole fraction of the component 1 plus mole fraction of the component 2, it is always equal to 1. So therefore, X2 it is equal to 1 minus X1. X2 it is equal to 1 minus X1. So this information we are having. Substituting this now in this equation now here. Okay, so we can write the equation here. Molar free energy of mixing, it is equal to RT. This term is remains at as it is. So substitute here X2. So it is 1 minus X1 into ln 1 minus X1. Okay, so we are getting this equation. 1 minus X1 into ln 1 minus X1. Now, the free energy is minimum. The free, what condition is given here? The free energy is minimum. In the problem, it is mentioned that in a binary gas mixture, the free energy of mixing is minimum. That condition is given here. So when the free energy of mixing is minimum, so let us see here. So to get this, we have to differentiate the above equation with respect to a mole fraction. So we can write this derivative of delta G of mixing, molar free energy of mixing, with respect to mole fraction dx. Okay, dx, it is equal to, so RT. So it is X1 dy dx ln X1. Okay. differentiating the above equation. Which equation? Once again, I would like to write that equation. Molar free energy of mixing. It is equal to. So it is RT into x1 ln x1 plus x2. X2 it is 1 minus x1, sorry, 1 minus x1 into ln 1 minus x1. Okay. So let us differentiate this equation with respect to this mole fraction. Okay, with respect to mole fraction. So RT x1 into derivative of this ln x1, differentiating this one, ln x1 into derivative of this x1. Okay, then here 1 minus x1 plus 1 minus x1 into derivative of this second term, and second term multiplied by derivative of the first term. So let us see what are the results here. So this is RT x1, derivative of ln x1, it is 1 upon x1. Okay, then ln x1 into derivative of this x1, it is also 1 here. So it is only ln x1, this is one part. Okay, now let us see the second term here, 1 minus x1 into derivative of this. So it is the derivative of ln 1 minus x1, it is 1 upon 1 minus x1 into derivative of this. So this term minus x1, it is here. So it is multiplied by minus 1. So you can see here, it is 1 minus x1 into 1 upon 1 minus x1. Okay. Then plus ln 1 minus x1 into minus x1, minus 1. So if we simplify this, we are getting this equation. Okay, so this plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled. So now we are getting this equation. You can see here, RT ln x1 minus ln 1 minus x1. Okay, so we can write this equation RT ln x1 upon 1 minus x1. So for free energy to be minimum, okay, when RT ln x1 upon 1 minus x1 becomes equal to 0. But in this equation, we cannot take RT equal to 0 because R is the gas constant, T is the temperature. So we can take second term becomes equal to 0. So it is ln x1 upon 1 minus x1, it is equal to 0. Okay. So we can take this becomes equal to 0. Now, if x1 upon 1 minus x1 equal to 1, then this is ln 1 equal to 0. It means that the value of this x1 upon 1 minus x1, it is equal to 1 here. The value of this, you can see here. Okay. This value, x1 upon 1 minus x1, it becomes equal to 1 here because it becomes equal to 0 when ln 1, it is 0. So therefore, we can write here ln x1 upon 1 minus x1, it is equal to 0. So x1 upon 1 minus x1, it is equal to 1. So we can write here x1, it is equal to 1 minus x1 according to this equation. So this is now, you can see, we can simplify this. So this x1 will be goes to this side. So it is plus x1. So x1 plus x1, it is equal to 1. So it is 2x1, it is equal to 1. So x1, it is equal to 1 by 2. Okay, x1, it is equal to 1 by 2. So you can see here, x1 it is equal to 1 by 2. So as x1 it is equal to 1 by 2, then x2 it is also equal to 1 by 2. Then we show that x1 it is equal to 1 by 2 and x2 it is equal to 1 by 2. Equimolar ratio, that is given in the problem. So thus, with the help of this free energy of the mixing, we prove here, you can see, we show x1 equal to x2 equal to 1 by 2.